Oh my. I don't know whether I want to say this answer because I know you're gonna pull up the photo and put it beside this interview. I regret a lot of my first red carpets because, gosh, I was just so young. I was like 14. I think there was I'm just gonna say it. There's a red carpet. It was my very first red carpet. I'm wearing like Victoria's Secret pink brand sports bra under a tank top and like Frankie B jeans, flip-flops, and a purse with a poodle on it, and which is exactly why you should not be famous as a child, because then all of these photos live forever on the internet.
First memory I have of Selena is my mom handing me the Amor Prohibido album and me looking at this badass woman with the pirate blouse, leather jacket, red lips, and putting that CD in the little stereo, and I remember my little face in the mirror being like, no me vuelvas a llamar, as if I knew like what that was like in life yet.
I don't necessarily have a first memory of Selena. I think I just kind of always felt her presence in the house because we always had her music playing.
I was in Cuernavaca. I was maybe 5-6 years old, and that's when our family would get together, and my parents would let me stay up a little later, so when they went to sleep, my prima Ileana would throw on Selena, and we would listen to Itibiri Bam Bam and Como La Flor, and me and my sister just remember thinking, like, this is a really cool, interesting vibe. So that's my earliest memory of Selena. Was Metallica Black. I just listened to that over and over and over. And at the same time, also Lou Bega's Mambo Number 5.
I think some of the first music I ever got was probably like an NSYNC album or like Christina Aguilera stripped album. I thought was like the best album I'd ever heard. And it's really good.
First album I was obsessed with was Crazy, Sexy, Cool by TLC. I had two covers of this same album. I don't know why I had that at 8 years old, but I'm a G.
Oh, well, I grew up competitive figure skating. I did that for like 13 years. And so I remember anything that I wanted usually pertained to ice skating. So like, I don't know, probably like over the boot tights or something.
Anything with tulle. Tulle skirt, chiffon, just something very feminine to add with a leather jacket. It's my haircut when I was a kid, that was a bob. I saw a woman with a bob and I was like, I want that. And then I, for the school picture, I decided to cover my eye to be rebelde. And I look so silly in this group class photo. And then it's just me being like, what's up?
Is dressing up. I know that suits look good and everything, but I just feel comfortable in t-shirts. So looking back, any time that I'm done up with anything more than just a t-shirt, I'm like, what are you doing, Julio? The first time that I wanted to be an actor was about a year after we moved to the United States. I was 8 years old, and I had always performed little things here and there for my family and Christmas and whatnot, but my mom signed me up for a youth opera, and this program, they would give us a play, like say Mother Goose or whatever, and we would have to every night play a different character. And after about a week of performing and changing from playing Mother Goose to the kid with no shoes to the cat in boots, I was just like, this. Whatever this is, changing characters, this is what I want to do.
First time I realized I wanted to be an actor, honestly, I started as a singer, and my good friend Gina told me, you know, I love seeing you sing, it's because you're in the moment, it's like you're acting. And I was like, acting? Acting? That's interesting. And then I took a class or two, but I really didn't take off, and so I went to school at UC Santa Barbara where I got my BFA in acting. And that's when I realized, I can do this. I will do this. My first acting role, well, I was a kid, I was nominated for a play. I think think truly my first acting role was honestly East Los High, Soli Gomez. And I love you guys, I love the fans, I love that story, and I worked with Gabe on East Los High, and that was my first job. Yeah, that was my first job in LA.
Was we all got together at Gabe's apartment, and Christian came over and we were playing charades, and everybody just kind of clicked in, and it was so much fun. There was bickering and rivalry. We were telling each other off as if we've known each other for 10 years, so that's when I knew. These are friends.
Oh, I don't know if I can say this. But one, Gabe was already a homie. Two, Sadie I met on a previous project. But when I really felt it was in our favorite bar right around here, it's one word, I won't say what it is, but specifically a very beautiful person asked me and Gabe, would you like a beer? And we, Gabe and I were like, yes, Mom, I would like a beer. We became like our characters in that moment, and we had a beautiful, festive, wonderful night. And as adults, as actors, and understanding this experience and our life.
What I would want people to pay attention to in the first season of Selena is seeing how young she actually started and her dedication not only to the singing, but the art of performing.
The icon you know is coming, and enjoy all of these moments learning about this very young girl and her quest to figure out who she is and what she wants and how she wants to be perceived and the energy that she puts in to get there.
What I would want people to know about Selena series season one is to come in with fresh eyes, open perspective, and let it just enter your heart and enjoy.